Assalamualaikum students, how are you? I hope you have a good time. Last class we discussed on the safe use of ICT and the maintenance of hardware, how to take care of your keyboard, mouse and other things. Today we will discuss on software maintenance. So today's topic is software maintenance. Software maintenance. Before starting this topic, we have to know what is software. What is software? Software is a set of instructions. Okay? Software is a set of instructions. The set of instructions that tells computer what to do. So software is the set of instructions that tells computer what to do, how to do. Okay. Suppose this is human body, very bad one, but suppose this hand, legs can be compared by hardware, and the mind that controls your body, the whole thing, it can be compared with software. So mind is software. Okay, so the software is controlling the whole thing. That means we have to maintain software very properly. Improper maintenance of software can be faced many problems. What problems? The number one problem is computer virus. Do you know what is virus? Real virus, that is real. It is germs. It can causes. It can cause the flu and flu, cold, and the most popular virus nowadays is coronavirus. But computer virus. It is not actually germ. It is a set of instructions, we know. It is also a software. It is a programming. Computer virus is not a germ. It doesn't cause any disease, but it is a little programming. A programming. A real virus is, real one is a germ that causes many diseases. Okay? Second thing is, real virus is what happened? It spreads one person to another person. We know that coronavirus spreads one person to another person very fastly. Same thing is happened here. Computer virus also spreads here one computer to another computer. It spreads one computer to another. Another computer. Okay. And it spreads one person to another person. Do you know when real virus attacks a human body, it multiplies its number. Suppose first time it was like 1, then it becomes 2, 4. It multiplies its number. Same thing also happens here. The virus, when attacks the computer, it also multiplies its number. 1, 2, 2. Okay. When a real virus attacks human body, it doesn't take any permission. Is coronavirus take the permission? Ma'am, may I come in? Virus can virus, any virus can tell you, it attacks people unknowingly. The person cannot know when and how it will be attacked. Okay, and the same thing, the computer virus, it attacks the computer unknowingly. Okay, the person cannot know when it attacks the computer. These things are the similarities, real virus and computer virus. Similarities are this, and what is the difference? Real virus is exists in the nature, okay, and computer virus is made by some dishonest person. It is a program, it is written by some dishonest person. Why? To harass other people. Understand, real virus is available in the nature, it's natural thing, but computer virus is written by a person, by some dishonest person, not a good person, some dishonest person written this program to harass other people. Okay, clear? And now, so what to do? Computer virus, how does it spreads? How does it spread, computer virus? By network. When you use computer network, the virus automatically comes. Okay, then the virus can attack your computer. Okay, by using computer network. And another thing is by CD, by using CD and pen drive. When you copy some data or information from others, from CD or pen drive, it can attack your computer. Okay. So how can we protect our computer from computer virus? It's very simple, by installing antivirus software. Antivirus software is also a program. This software is written in such a way that it can kill the virus. Okay, and we have to update it. It is very important. Why we need to update it regularly? Because all the time new viruses have arrived, new viruses discovered. So if we don't update, it cannot work. It cannot kill the viruses. So we have to update our antivirus regularly. So we discussed on software maintenance. This topic is completed here. And now, health hazard. Health. Milk. Do you drink milk regularly? Yes, milk is very nutritious food for a child. A glass of milk you have to take regularly, one glass or two glass. It's very nutritious food, we know that. But a dram. Jam. A drum full of milk, if you throw a child to this, what will happen? There is a possibility to be drawn, the child can be drawn in the milk. A thing is good, but excess of any good thing is not good. We know internet and computer technology is good for us, but excess use of anything is bad. We have to be very careful about the uses of computer, internet, computer technology. So many problems can arise if someone sits for a long time in front of computer. Back pain is very, very common, back pain, then finger pain, problem in eyes. These problems are very common, so don't use the computer excessively, okay? Another new problem is social media. The new trend is you have to make friendship online, okay? Not real relationship, you have to make social network, okay? So making friendship online, social networking site. So these sites make people unsocial. So don't use this social networking sites. Make friendship in real. Okay. So we can say that we have to remember it. You will use the computer, the technology, but technology may not use you. Okay. We have to remember it. So that's all for today. Next class we will discuss another topic. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.